Same again, please, guys. We'll take questions from English-speaking media first, and then we'll come to Spanish-speaking media after that, please. Somewhere to start? Hands up in a big room full of people, please, guys. Thank you. Sam?
Hi, Pep. You've obviously got a huge history with Real Madrid, and last year added to that. What does it mean for you to play in this stadium and be in this city?
Well, it's not the first time. It's a competition, like everybody knows, quarterfinals. First leg, focus on what you have to do, try to discover the strength points and our rival, and go for it. So try to focus, it's a football game.
Just to Ben in the middle, please. Thank you.
Hi, Pep. I remember the games that Jude Bellingham played against you for Borussia Dortmund when he was 17. Showed a lot of maturity to my rather inexperienced eye. But I wonder, you've come up against him since as a player. How have you seen him develop? And what were your first impressions of him when you saw him in those matches?
Well, play with 70 years old when, yeah, we faced one or twice with Borussia Dortmund. And I said, in terms of not just the skills, because I think the difference is what he has in his brain, in his mind. And of course, he came in this club with the exceptional players, with a manager like Carlo that have the incredible ability to know exactly the best position for which one. And Carlo found him. So click quick and have done an incredible season in terms of goals, assists. He's present in the box. But not just with Madrid, the national team from UK, from England, always he has been brilliant. So it's just 19, 20 years old he has. So he has a long, long career ahead of him.
Jack.
Hiya, Pep. Obviously, there's no Kyle Walker here. Nathan Ake is not here. Guardiol didn't train today, but has travelled.
He travelled.
Is he fit?
He's doubted.
A doubt.
Yeah.
How much of a headache has that been for you, particularly in the right back area, and decide what to do? Or has your job actually been made easier by the injuries?
Well, it's what it is. So also Madrid, Courtois, Militao, Alaba have been for a long time with that players. It's true that the best player to control a player like Vinicius is Kyle. Unfortunately, with a friendly game, was injured. Now it's what it is. So we'd love to have him, but what can I say? So we play with 11 and try to adapt for the players that we have, because inches is part of the long seasons, but unfortunately in the decisive part, have a lot of inches in the same department in the back four and have to find a solution. We think tonight a little bit more what we have to do and try to get a good result for the second leg.
Fred?
Hi, Pep. Because of last season, Real Madrid are undoubtedly hurt. And I believe you understand the power of being hurt, because that's why how Manchester City arrived here last time, because of the season before. Can you use their thirst for revenge in your favour?
No, it's last season. Two seasons ago, we were out for the last minutes here. Last season, we won. Looks like a classic, between them and ourselves in the last years, but no, I don't have the feeling that this is where it is last season. So he's right, the same managers, not a long time ago. But new players we have, they have new players. So completely different games. And of course, we have a little advantage for the fact the second leg is at home. Like, we feel strong, we are incredibly confident, but we have to play first 90 minutes here and here. The games are long for many reasons. Expect different games in the same game. They will be able to incredible press high, so aggressive. They are so dangerous. If you are able to do a good process, they will drop. They will defend a low block. But after, everybody knows, not Pep, everybody knows the strength for the transitions that they have, not just with Vinicius, for Rodrigo, Bellingham, Ronay, Valverde. So they have an incredible pace to do this. That's why you have to, but at the same time, you cannot come here just to control the game. You have to go here to try to hurt them, to punish them, to try to let them feel we are here to score goals. And in that mix, you have to read how you have to do, how you control it. So we are talking about Real Madrid that has the ability to control many, many aspects of the game. In the same time, to have to, with who we are, try to impose our game.
Jamie.
Hi, Pep. Right. Hello. Carlo said earlier today that in the game you beat them at the Etihad last year, he said his team, Real, had played with, quote, no personality. Mm. First of all, are you surprised to hear him say that? And secondly, can you do the same, make them play without any personality?
No, I'm not going to don't be agree with Carlo for the huge admiration I have to him. It's not about that. It's just sometimes when you are, I have experience, because I was in Barcelona, like we can be equal for a consideration Real Madrid. When Real Madrid lose, it's the people think it was a really, really bad. And they have to think that the other team was better. And in football, it happened. That game, we were better. Not because Real Madrid was bad, I would say. So we make a really, really a lot amount of good things. That, but in that clubs, always we are judged. We were really bad, was not good. I tried to think differently. So sometimes I came here, they beat me, was a football player for a good game. And I can say, they were not bad, they were better. It's football, football game, can happen.
Can you perform like that again, the same? As good as that this time?
It's difficult. Because beat Real Madrid two times in the same way is almost impossible. So beat once in this competition is difficult. Imagine two in a row. So the target is not easy. And performing that well, because they learn, they have pride, and they have to try to be smart tomorrow. They're going to have to play and see what happened in the second leg.
One more in English with Dave, please.
Hi, Pep. Rodri was just in talking about how winning this competition last season has given, in his opinion, the team a maturity and a serenity and a belief. Do you sense that change in mentality and mindset? And do you see that in your players, that you can go on and dominate this competition and have the belief that you can, you know, overcome the likes of Real Madrid?
But first, is I would say as a club, it's a sense of relief. So we make a lot of good things this season, but always in the press conference, in arrived at 7 years ago, but you didn't win the Champions League, you have to win the Champions League, otherwise we'll not complete. Always I try to reject it because these competitions are difficult, and I would say we are a little bit more than one decade that we are flying in Europe. Before we didn't fly in Europe, and now we are a club like face this type of competition with the best teams of the world. But it's no more than one decade, and decade is not enough. Even for now, compete again is experience for the future for our club. People say, once we have won it, it's done. No, absolutely not. It's not like elite clubs like Madrid, Bayern Munich, Barcelona, Inter de Milan, for example, or the clubs with the big, big clubs that fed for 40, 50, 60, 70 years playing this competition. We are, I would say, in terms of history, new. But we have a sense of, okay, we did it. We did it. And of course, if we did once, we can do it again. And being again, after what happened last season, being again here in quarterfinals, making an incredible group stage, winning all the games, winning the last 16, and being here is really good. It's really good for us. And of course, we knew it last season, two seasons ago, three or four seasons ago we played. We have to do a real two good games, you know, to... Otherwise, but not Real Madrid in this competition, play against Bayern Munich or Arsenal right now, or Barcelona or PSG. You have to do a good two games, not just one game. So it's impossible. So I think the level that we have is more similar to the game we played last season here, that there was equal, that it was some moments were better, some moments they were better, more than the game we played the second leg, or the game we played in 2 years ago in Etihad in Manchester, that we win just 4-3, and we're much, much better than them. So I think we are quite similar, and I think tomorrow and the second leg will be, I hope, I imagine, will be in that way.
Take some questions in Spanish. Is that over there, please?
Hola, ¿qué tal? Pep, muy buenas. Anton Meana de la cadena SER, un placer volver a verle por aquí.
Igualmente.
Le han preguntado esta mañana a Carlo en conferencia de prensa, vamos a llamarlo un tópico, un mantra, le han dicho Guardiola es un gran entrenador y usted un gran gestor. Y Carlo ha dicho que no contestaba sobre él, que eso ya lo haría su club, pero que sobre usted sí, que es un gran entrenador. No sé qué le parece esa apreciación. Usted es un gran entrenador, Carlos, un gran gestor, o qué nos quiere decir de...
Usted no sabe lo que es difícil ser un buen gestor. Los atributos de un entrenador no solo son la cuestión táctica, o la cuestión táctica, la cuestión delante de usted, la cuestión la gestión con los jugadores, cómo gestionar los buenos momentos, ser estable tú mismo en los buenos y malos momentos, millones de factores que hacen ser un buen entrenador. Pero jamás, jamás puedo llegar a considerar de que Carlo es un mal entrenador tácticamente. Si no, no pondría, hubiera puesto a Pirlo como medio centro en el Milan en su mejor, seguiría mintiendo a Toni Kroos como medio centro bajo, ni adaptar rapidísimamente a Bellingham para que pueda explotar. Esto es ser parte de un entrenador. Un entrenador que lleva tantos años teniendo tanto éxito, yo sé que a veces le dicen de manera despectiva, tiene que saber por mi parte que no se los crea, que desde Manchester tenemos una opinión muy alta sobre quién es.
Bona nit, Pep. En català per TV3. Fins a quin punt va resultar alliberadora la victòria l'any passat 4-0? Perquè des d'aleshores el Manchester City ha aconseguit 10 victòries consecutives en la Champions amb contundència, aixecant el títol i havent començat aquesta temporada fins ara, els 8 partits que s'han disputat, doncs amb aquesta claredat.
Alliberadora va ser guanyar la Champions. El Madrid ja l'havien guanyat fa 2, 3 o 4 anys, l'any del Covid, i el vam eliminar i no vam guanyar la Champions. Per tant, no és alliberadora. Alliberadora és quan la guanyes. I això sí que ho va ser. I, evidentment, per guanyar la Champions has de guanyar el Madrid, el PSG, els grans equips d'Europa. Si no, no la pots guanyar.
Pep, por acá, Eduardo Vidal, de HSM Deportes. Siendo un entrenador que ha conseguido tanto en su carrera, ¿cómo haces actualmente para mentalmente seguir manteniendo esa exigencia en la actualidad, no con el equipo, sino a nivel personal? Gracias.
Me gusta este negocio. Me lo paso bien. Me pagan bien y me lo paso muy bien. Esta es la verdad. Aún me gusta la competición, me gusta venir aquí, intentar seguir adelante. Me gusta ir al campo lucho, no al campo del último partido que jugamos. Me gusta. Aún me lo paso bien. El día que no, pues me iré a casa. No hay otra razón.
Pep, acá. João Ventura, SBT Brasil. 8 equipos en los cuartos, 4 entrenadores, fueron jugador de Barcelona. Te pregunto si eso se puede decir que es una coincidencia o hace parte de una ideología de quien pasa por Barcelona. Gracias.
También en la Premier League hay muchos entrenadores vascos, muchísimos, que nos están haciendo increíble. No lo sé. Mikel estuvo un pelín menos en la Academia en Barcelona. Mikel viajó rápido a otros países, a Escocia, a Francia. Pero sí que es verdad que Xavi, Luis Enrique y mío, yo puedo hablar por mí, la influencia de Barcelona fue muy, muy grande en mi formación en el campo y sobre todo ahora como entrenador. Pero el viajar a Alemania, ahora estar en Inglaterra, no soy el mismo cuando estaba en Barcelona. He aprendido muchísimo de las dificultades que cada liga te ponen y el tiempo, la experiencia te da esto, conocer más cosas. Pero la influencia del Barça en mí es todo, ha sido todo. Llegué con 13 años, siendo un rejo pelotas en la academia y mira dónde hemos llegado.
Hola Pep, Fermín de la calle del periódico, por aquí. Nos ha dicho Carlos hoy que aprendió mucho del partido de vuelta del año pasado. Yo quería preguntarte qué aprendisteis vosotros con la goleada y con la clasificación, si también aprendisteis tanto como ellos, que salieron derrotados.
Teníamos un nivel emotivo, emocional, ese partido inmenso. Sacamos un buen resultado aquí, que podía con 1-0 estaba muy peligroso. Si nos hubieran hecho el segundo hubiera sido muy difícil. Y llevamos un nivel emotivo muy grande, primero por llegar a la final, que ya es suficiente, por lo que pasó el año anterior, de que lo teníamos muy cerca, porque en el 0-1 aquí tuvimos dos para sentenciarlo, luego Rodrigo hizo de las suyas. Y el Bernabéu y todo lo que significa ese estadio, y eso estuvo muy muy presente en la preparación, en la vuelta, en muchas cosas, pero lo mismo que lo he dicho, hace 2 años pasó y ahora ha cambiado. Es decir, mañana sé que será diferente. Carlo habrá buscado algo de que le pudimos hacer, buscar alternativas, y nosotros hemos de cambiar algo por la forma. No tenemos los defensas que tenemos, nos falta piezas. Por tanto, habrá que buscar alguna manera para ver qué hacer. El partido será distinto, esto por supuesto. Primero porque es el primer partido de ida y los partidos de ida son totalmente en los de vuelta, donde ya te dejas ir porque ya no hay vuelta. En el primero siempre uno especula más. Intentaremos especular lo menos posible, sabiendo que jugar al Bernabéu siempre pesa.
Just one final question here, please.
Aquí Pep, Diego Plaza del Chiringuito. Ha dicho que sigue aquí porque le gusta este negocio, porque se lo pasa bien. ¿Qué le supone saltar mañana al Bernabéu, donde ha tenido buenos momentos y también momentos duros?
No es la primera vez. Ya es, no digo que es una rutina, que es, pero no es la primera vez. Es la primera vez cuando ya como jugador viene muchas veces y como entrenador también. Tanto ya es. Siempre es especial. Bernabéu, Camp Nou, cuando vas al Allianz Arena o vas a estos campos, siempre Anfield, todos estos, Old Trafford, todos estos campos, cada vez que vas son especiales, pero ya. Ya hemos venido muchas veces.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.